upper half.
And these four principles that are of the body, took them from the Quran and from the Sunnah.
وأراد بهذه القواعد على ما ذكرنا الرد على الشبه التي يأتي بها الشك في زمان.
And as we mentioned previously, that the author, when he mentioned these four principles, he wanted to dispel or refute some of the doubts that the people of Shirk have at all time.
القاعدة الأولى.
So the first principle is
أو الشبهة الأولى نذكر القاعدة مع الشبه حتى تفهم.
Oh, the first doubt is, so we're going to mention the doubt along with the principles so that you can understand.
لو قال لك المشرك أو المبطل أو الذي يعني يناقشك في ما هو واقع فيه من الشرك نسأل الله السلامة عليه.
So if a mushrik comes to you and he argues with you, or if a person who's debating you and he wants to debate you against the things that he is doing, that is shirk.
إذا قال لك الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الخالق والرازق والمحيي والمميت والمدبر.
If this person, this mushrik or this person who's arguing with you, if he comes to you and he says, look, Allah, he is the Razik, he's the one who gives sustenance. He's the one who created, he's the one who controls affairs, he's the one who is ever living and gives life, he's the one who gives death. And I accept this, I believe in this.
فكيف تنكر علي هذه الأمور التي تقول عنها أنها
So why are you now forbidding me and telling me off for these things which I am doing, and you're saying that this is shit when I accept all these things I've just mentioned?
وأنا مقر بأن الله هو الخالق والرازق والمحيي والمميت والمدبر.
So why are you talking against me? Why are you debating with me about these things which are, and you call them shit, and yet I accept that Allah, He is the one who is the Razik, He gives sustenance, He gives life, He gives death.
نقول هذا الكلام الذي تذكر من أن الله هو الخالق وكذا هو توحيد الربوبية.
We say that these matters which you are mentioning, i.e. Allah is al-Razik, the one who gives sustenance, He gives life, He gives death, He controls everything. This relates to Tawheed al-Rububiyyah.
وهذا التوحيد أقر بالكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أقر بتوحيد الربوبية.
And this Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, and the meaning of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah that we mentioned is an affirmation of singling out Allah in His actions, or singling out Allah that He is the Khaliq, Malik, Razik, like we mentioned yesterday. The Shaykh said that you say to this person that these things that you're mentioning, this is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. And this Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, even the Mushrikun, even the polytheists and the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Quraysh, they used to mention this, they used to affirm this, they used to believe in this.
وَلَمْ يَدْخَلَهُمْ هَذَا فِي الْإِسْلَامِ إِلَى قَرَبَ تَوْحِيدَ الْرُبُوبِيَّةِ.
And yet, their belief and the acceptance of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah never entered them into paradise.
فَلَا أَكْفِي هَذَا.
So therefore this isn't enough.
وَإِلَّا فَأَنْتَ مُوَافِقُ لِلْكُفَّارِ الَّذِينَ بَعَثَهُمُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ.
Otherwise, you are in agreement with the disbelievers that the Prophet was sent to.
لا بد أن تفرد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأنواع التوحيد الثلاثة الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
But rather, you have to single out Allah, you have to have the Tawheed of Allah in all of these three things. ربوبية and ألوهية in your actions and your worship and أسماء والصفات.
إذا كل من صار شيء من العبادة لغير الله فقد وافق الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And therefore, anybody who directs any act of worship that is meant to be for Allah to other than Allah, then he has resembled and he has conformed to those people, the disbelievers, to whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent.
لأنهم أقروا بتوحيد الربوبية.
Because they, the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they accepted توحيد الربوبية.
وكان عندهم شيء من العبادة لله.
And they used to have some aspects of worshiping Allah.
وشيء لغير الله.
And some aspects of worshiping other than Allah.
فلا بد أن تكون العبادة كلها لله.
And therefore worship, all of it has to be for Allah.
إذن هذه القاعدة الأولى.
So therefore this is the first principle.
أن الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أقروا بتوحيد الربوبية.
So the first principle is they should know that the kuffar, the disbelievers to whom the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to, they themselves used to accept and believe in توحيد الربوبية.
وتخاصموا أو خالف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في توحيد الألوهية مع أنه كان عندهم شيء من توحيد الألوهية العبودية. نعم.
And their opposition of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Their argumentation of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it was in their worship in توحيد الألوهية. Even though they used to have some aspects of the worship of Allah and they used to have some aspects of worshiping other than Allah.
القاعدة الثانية.
The second principle.
أو الشبهة الثانية مع القاعدة.
Or the second doubt along with the principle of the answer.
لو قال لك هذا المبطل أو المشرك.
So if this person who is debating with you, if this person who is in shirk, if he said to you,
أنا لا أعبد هؤلاء.
I don't worship those things. I don't worship them.
أنا مقر من العبادة حق لله ولا يصح أن يصرف منها شيء غير الله.
I accept and I understand and appreciate that العبادة worship is only for the sake of Allah and it is not correct for anybody besides Allah.
وقال أنه يريد من هؤلاء أي من أصحاب القبور ومن الأولياء ومن ذلك يريد منهم القرب والشفاعة.
But he says.
أن يقربوا إلى الله. نعم.
But he says. But the only thing I want from those objects that he's directing these actions to is I just want them to take me close to Allah. I only want them to intercede on my behalf, shafa' and qurba. This is all I want from them. I don't worship them.
يعني يريد من هؤلاء أن يشفعوا له عند الله أو يقربوا إلى الله. نعم. المهم ما يعبد من دون الله.
So those objects of worship, the idols and the trees, the people, the grave or whatever. He says, the only thing I want from them when I do these actions to them is that they take me close to Allah. And they have intercession or they intercede on my behalf in front of Allah.
كيف نرد عليه؟
So then how do we refute or repel this doubt and refute this person?
نقول هذا الكلام الذي تذكر هو كلام الكفار.
We say to him that this very same statement that you are making, this is the same statement of the disbeliever.
وبهذا الكلام أي بطلب القرب والشفاعة كفرهم الله.
And because of this statement, because those kuffar, they used to say that we only seek closeness and intercession to Allah. Because of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them and considered them to be disbelievers.
والدليل
and the evidence
ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربون الله زلفا.
That Allah says in the Quran that these people, they say ما نعبدهم, that we don't really worship these objects except ليقربون الله زلفا, that they only take us close to Allah.
هؤلاء شفعاءنا عند الله.
And Allah says in the Quran that these people say that those objects of worship they are our intercessors in front of Allah, on behalf of Allah.
إذن القاعدة الثانية.
And therefore the second principle is
أن هؤلاء يقولوا أننا لا نعبد هؤلاء بل نريد منهم القرب والشفاعة.
So the second principle is that those people, the people who are debating with you, they will say that we don't worship these people, we don't worship these objects. But we only want from them to proceed on our behalf or take us close to Allah.
القاعدة الثالثة.
The third principle.
ونذكر القاعدة مع الشبهة.
And again, we mentioned the doubt and the principle.
لو قال لك المشرك أو المبطل.
If this person who is doing shirk or this person who is debating and arguing with you, if he said to you,
هذه الآيات التي يحتج بها للسنة والجماعة.
That these verses that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah use as an evidence
نزلت في من يعبد الأصنام.
These evidences they were revealed upon those people who only worship the idols.
والأحجار والشمس والقمر.
And they only worship the stones and the trees and the sun.
وهؤلاء يعني أهل الشرك في زمان يقولوا نحن يعني أي هم يعني يعبدون الأولياء والصالحين فكيف تجعل يحتج علينا أقول كيف تجعل الآيات التي نزلت في من يعبد الأصنام تنطبق على الأولياء والصالحين هذا شرك بالنسبة للأحجار والأشجار ولكن ليس شرك بالنسبة للصالحين ولا يوجد دليل على كفر من عبد الصالحين
so,
هذه الشبهة
So these people are debating with you, this person is in shirk. The doubt that he's going to bring now, after these two doubts, he's going to bring a third doubt. He's saying, look, the verses, the ayat, and the ahadith that you're using, the evidence that you're using. The evidences that you're using, the Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah use against us. These evidences, they were revealed on people who used to worship stones, idols, trees and the sun. However, we direct our actions of worship to the righteous people, the awliya, the prophets, the righteous people. So how can you therefore use these evidences against us, and yet these evidences were revealed against people who worship trees and idols. Yet we worship or we direct our actions to the righteous people and the prophets. So therefore, the response to them is
أنا نذكر الآيات والأحاديث التي فيها أن الله سبحانه وتعالى كفر من عبد الصالحين.
He is that we mention to them the evidences, the ayat and the ahadith, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala considered as disbelievers those people who direct an act of worship to the righteous people, the salihin. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He even considered as disbelievers those people who worship angels. And He considered disbelievers those people who worship the prophets. As well as the trees and the sun and the idols. In fact, everything which is worshipped besides Allah, anything and everything.
وقال سبحانه وتعالى وَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَحِدُ اللَّهِ.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah, meaning يُوَحِدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah purely, sincerely, for Him only.
وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا.
And Allah said in the Quran that do not ascribe any partner, shay'an, any partner to Allah.
وشيئا هنا نكرة تعم كل ما يعبد من دون الله نبي أو ولي أو جني أو صالح أو ملك أو حجر أو شجر أو قمر أو غيرها.
And here in this ayah where Allah said ولا تشركوا به شيئا, that do not associate anything with Allah. Here anything, this word شيئا is come like this on its own, meaning anything, righteous, unrighteous, prophet, angel, tree, anything.
ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أتى بالقاعدة الرابعة.
And then the author, may Allah mercy upon him, he came with the fourth principle.
أننا نخوف هؤلاء. نخوف هؤلاء ونحذرهم.
Is that we frighten those people and we warn them.
ونقول لهم.
And we say to them.
الكفار الذين بعثهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That the disbelievers to which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to.
أخلصوا في الضراء. وأشركوا في السراء.
They would make their supplications and their worship sincere to Allah in times of need. However, in times of blessing and ease, then they would start committing shirk.
وكفرهم الله.
And yet, despite this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala considered them as disbelievers.
وأهل الشرك في زماننا نسأل الله السلامة والعافية.
As for the people of shirk in our time, we ask for safety and pardon.
شركهم دائم في السراء والضراء.
Then they shirk is always, every time, in times of difficulty and times of ease.
فنقول لهم اتقوا الله.
So we should say to them, اتقوا الله, fear Allah.
وأقلعوا عن الشرك.
And leave alone this shirk, leave it alone, abandon it.
لأن هذا الشرك الذي يعني عند أهل الشرك في زماننا أشد من الشرك الذي كان زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهم كفار من باب أولى.
So, and we say to them, fear Allah, leave alone this shirk, because the shirk which is with the people of shirk in our times is more severe than the shirk that was with the people at the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And therefore, the shirk, or the people who are doing shirk in this time, are more disbelievers than them. It's more severe in their disbelief.
نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلامة والعافية.
We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us and pardon us.
وفق الله الجميع المحب ورضا الله أعلم وصلى الله على النبي محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
And may Allah guide everybody to that which Allah is pleased with and He loves. وصلى الله على النبي.